Co stalo?
11. září roku 2001 vyšlo nad New Yorkem slunce v 6 hodin a 32 minut. Bylo 66 stupňů Fahrenheita, tedy necelých 19 stupňů Celsia. Jasno, vál slabý vítr. 7.59 vzlétl z bostonského letiště Boeing 760.
V New Yorku 411 metrů.
Tohle jsou nejvyšší dvě budovy v New Yorku. 411 metrů.
57. Let číslo 11. Měl namířeno do Los Angeles. O 15 minut později startuje z bostonského letiště do Los Angeles let číslo 175. V tu chvíli se pan Hlava a jeho bratr chystají se svým šéfem na cestu z Brooklynu do Pensylvánie. První letadlo narazilo do severu.
Vidíš, wow!
Oh, Mike, stop! Stop!
Ty malo.
Mike, stop, please.
Oh my God.
Yankee, mother.
Oh my God.
Mike, stop. Stop, Mike.
Divaguje.
Jak to lítá popel. Ty mother.
Tak před chvílou jsme to kamerovali a dvojičky byly v pohodě, teď už hoří.
Jak se může dostat, asi či se může dostat.
Ty vole.
Vrtulník tam je. Ty brodě.
Mike, out je?
Neuvěřitelné, dvojičky hoří. Já to mám na kameře. Já to mám natočené! Mike! Hej, já to mám natočený!
Čo to je atentát, brácho? To není normální. Ty to máš to letadlo natočený?
Jo, jo. Hej!
Did they say what's going on?
Two planes just crashed. Two big ones. Let's
go, bro. The phone doesn't work. There's an antenna on the top. It's an attentat. It's not normal.
Bro, I have to do it. Pojďme pryč, nebo tu se ještě něco víc stane, vole.
Kamaráde, to není normální, ty atentát, brácho.
Ticho.
Co ticho?
Mike, jak to mám?
I saw.
Look.
Daj mi to cilku.
One, nine, one, seven.
No,
dáme
telefon,
dáme
telefon.
OK,
pravote. Normálně dopravní letadlo to napálilo.
Já jsem to viděl, brácho. Já to točím, celý furt. Deset sekund,
есть антенны?
Да, да, да.
Для самолета?
Да.
Наверное, когда первый самолет упал, он убил антенну, потому что мой телефон не работает. А второй самолет пошел прямо, потому что он не знает, куда он идет, он не видит. Понимаешь?
Понимаю.
Ty vole, ale mohl hodnout do nás,
vole.
Lidi, když jsme byli tam, tak on na nás spadl.
Ale co Pavlík řekl, zastaví se, zastaví.
Ale je ne, že jsi řekl, že aby zastavil. Že bychom byli pod tím, kdyby akorát se zastavil. Zkazala, zastaví se.
A kde je to letadlo? Jak on mrdl nebo kde? A kde ono je, vole? Vole, ho mám to letadlo, jak letělo.
No ne, ale že ho musel proučit tím domem, to není.
Ale kde ono spadlo to?
Na ulic, ne?
Ty kuchu.
Ale říká Mike, že říká, že zvykla by zůstal, když jsem byl na potřeba.
Jo.
Už se nedostaneš vůbec odsaď teďka.
Teď mi ještě někdo nezabalí kameru, vole.
Počkej, mě jde nějaký výbor.
Počkej, já půjdu víc do boku, tady. Neviděl. Z které budovy?
insane. Let's go.
What car is this?
It's your car?
What car is this?
Come on.
I came down here, I said, I was calling and what kind of airplane that was.
That was about 9:20, about 18 minutes later, the second one happened in the other building, and in both cases, all the eyewitnesses who called have told us that it looked as though it were intentional, nobody was trying to miss.
That guy, he just did the way he might be, but he didn't look like he was veering off, and it went right directly into the building, and it was like, God, what the fuck is it? You can't believe it.
inside.
Into the building. We have yet to hear word one.
Breaking news on WCBS 880, right here, right now.
We're covering more terror at the World Trade Center 8 years later.
Two planes got smashed into the tower's minutes to cause the first coming about 8:50 this morning.
There's flame, heavy smoke pouring out along the flames at this moment, 45 minutes later.
The FBI is investigating reports of a hijacking before the crashes, and there was also word that they were looking into the possibility that it was a suicide attack. No word yet on possible deaths or injuries. The crashes have left some television stations in the city off the air. They happened about 18 minutes apart. Stay with us on WCBS 880. We have Tom Kaminsky overhead in Chopper 880. We have experts and eyewitnesses on the phone with us. Stay with us for continuing live team coverage. A little while ago, we were talking about the building started shaking. He's back with us now, right on the ground outside.
Yes, I am.
Are you seeing people coming out of the building?
Everything is ringed off here, and what I do see, unfortunately, are the bodies falling out of the north building. I've watched at least four bodies fall out of the building. There's still a great amount of smoke and fire, and here on the ground, everybody is very, very upset. There are people walking around holding their hearts. Women are crying. Everybody is talking about a conspiracy, and in the whole area as well. So the telephone lines for the outdoor phones are extremely long as people try to call their loved ones and tell them they're okay.
We're hearing reports from reporters who are getting closer and closer to the World Trade Center in the streets. Again, this is the first we're hearing about anyone inside the building. And David Levin is showing the people. There is no cell phone service in the area of Lower Manhattan. Sean Adams near City Hall, 15, 20 blocks away. He spoke of people lining up 50 deep to use pay phones. And at this point, Manhattan is sealed off.
You can't get in by either tunnel. And now there is also word that apparently the entire city is sealed off. So that would likely include the George Washington Bridge.
Yeah, I just said Manhattan is sealed off as opposed to the city. You can't get across the Brooklyn Battery Tunnel. Hudson River crossings are closed. And again, as Tom Kaminsky has been telling us, no air traffic. Given the traffic patterns coming toward the building as the planes were seen by eyewitnesses, that it is likely this plane, described as maybe a 737, maybe a 767, the second plane, would have been coming from LaGuardia.
We have another eyewitness on the phone with us, Juanita Soto in Brooklyn. What have you been able to see?
Well, we were in the roof, my husband and I, to see the plane, to see it from the roof.
Obviously, we are on full terrorism alert in New York City. President Bush has mentioned this as a possible terrorist act. We have people on the ground telling us they have terror in the streets in Lower Manhattan, people panicking, people crying. One witness has told us he saw a couple of bodies actually fall out of one of the buildings. What happened was within 18 minutes apart, two different planes crashed into each separate tower of the World Trade Center. It would seem, by all accounts, intentionally.
So what we know now at this point is that apparently two large planes have collided into the towers of the World Trade Center, and Manhattan is sealed off from the world. The bridges, the tunnels closed. No air traffic. No helicopter traffic can get anywhere near the World Trade Center. The TV helicopters are Chopper 880. No one can get close at this point. The airspace around New York City is in the middle of the World Trade Center. I've got to look around it because I have a
We had been in that area just south of the World Trade Center and really had not been in that area for longer than 30 seconds. We had gone north and the second explosion occurred.
Did you feel the wave of the explosion?
You know, we couldn't feel the wave of any explosion. However, the flash in this instance certainly caught our eye. And in fact, that was the second explosion that we had seen, with the second plane going into tower number 2. And it would not have been more than 2 minutes prior to its impact.
No.
So it's been just an amazing.
No. No pilot in his right mind is going to fly anywhere near, particularly a big airplane, the World Trade Center.
Charlie, you know the air corridors in this region like the back of your hand. Can you guess which airport or where these planes might come
from anywhere in the United States? They didn't have to take off from here, my friend. They didn't have to come from LaGuardia or Kennedy.
They could be on their way there.
They could be on their way there. They could have been taken from Omaha, Nebraska, for all we know.
Interesting, in all the eyewitnesses we've spoken to, nobody mentioned any markings on the tail of either plane or jetliner company in Sydney or anything like that.
Sure, it could very well have been an airplane that was hijacked yesterday. Somebody put some paint on, that sort of thing. We just don't know the answers, and that's all conjecture. But if nobody saw any markings, then that is a very inexplicable and interesting kind of a point, if that's in fact the case.
It isn't a Cessna that can create a 30-story fireball, which is what it looked like as the second plane flew directly in.
I mean, a Cessna loaded with the same kind of explosive that made a hole in the side of the pole, yes, that could make a giant hole in the side of the World Trade Center. So it's possible for a small plane to do it if it's loaded with explosives. If, on the other hand, you have no explosives and you want to make a big fireball, get it together.
All right, thank you. Charlie Kern, who is a flight instructor and very familiar with the airspace over the New York City area.
So you see the FU team, we sending a lot of reporters to cover this story for you, and here's one of them now. Peter Haskell is live at Chelsea Piers.
And we can get a clear view down the west on the highway. Cars have been backed up.
Charlie Carnes, where those planes might have been hijacked.
To the Pentagon, according to witnesses. First, we have the two planes that have crashed into the World Trade Center towers here in New York, and now the Pentagon.
Like a replay of what happened in New York about exactly 1 hour ago, we are now looking at a live picture by CBS News and our resources in Washington, D.C., of huge white smoke billowing out of the five-sided buildings in Washington. This is the first world to get into the situation in the nation's capital. Again, as things broke moment by moment, we learned only a moment ago that one of the planes that hit in New York came from Boston, where it was hijacked.
The West Wing of the White House has now been evacuated amid terrorist threats. That is also just coming across the wires now from Washington. A plane moments ago was crashed into the Pentagon in Washington, and now they are evacuating the West Wing of the White House.
Understand.
telling us earlier, cell phone communications have been disrupted, much like communications were disrupted from the TV stations for at least a brief time. So it's the fifth on top of the World Trade Center North Tower.
Stojím pod Brooklyn Bridgem a točím. Po Brooklyn Bridge následuje katastrofa. Původně jsem chtěl natočit naši cestu do Pennsylvanie a vidíte, co z toho vzniklo.
Celý spadlo.
That is a tremendous building, one of the largest in the world, and it's just apparently coming down.
We first noticed the first plane crash into the first tower.
You have so many. Mike, stop, stop, please. Please, no more.
The city looks like it is in ruins from the vantage point of looking where the tower just crashed into lower Manhattan.
The smoke that is surrounding the World Trade Center and billowing out in the
blocks around, if you take a panoramic view of the city, it looks as if there were dark, dirty
bombs. Fully in the benefit of one. Bomb, BG. Ah,
because they can't use their cell phones, and they're probably likely to get a bit of panic.
Just happened in the past moment, and we wish we could tell.